Hello veterinary friends, welcome to youtube.com Dr. Ved channel. I am Dr. P.R. Patel, Professor and Head Veterinary Medicine. Today's topic is a very important topic, and mostly the pups and the neonates and young ones are suffering from important disease called pneumonia. It is a very common disease among the young ones. It is divided into several parts. In part 1, we will cover the definition, introduction, classification of pneumonia, etiology, mode of transmission of infection, and the relevant portion will be covered here. Pneumonia occurs in all animals, and especially domestic animals suffer much. Pneumonia is defined as acute or chronic inflammation of the lungs and bronchi, mainly the alveoli. It is called as lung parenchyma. Pneumonia is characterized by disturbance in respiration. Respiration becomes rapid and shallow because there is less space for the oxygen to enter. Important sign is the coughing. Cough is the reflex action due to irritation of inflammation and because of the mucus. Reflex action to remove that mucus, there is coughing. Whenever there is infection, especially virus and bacteria, it is characterized by fever. Normally, the normal lungs has a blowing or wheezing sound when the air is passing through the ducts of lungs. But here there are adventitious other abnormal sounds also, and they are called as rills or bronchi. This disease causes a serious condition, hypoxia, lack of oxygen in the blood, and sometime in very severe condition, anoxia, total lack of oxygen, and there is death of animal. Many a time, the pneumonia is accompanied or complicated by many other system effects other than the lungs. Depends on the concurrent disease or associated etiology that causes the pneumonia. When the infection to the alveoli or lung parenchyma, it is not restricted to that only, but the infection is also shared to bronchi and bronchioles and causes the inflammation of bronchiole also. There the term is called as bronchopneumonia. As I said, the infection is not restricted. It shares the infection to the neighboring organ also. Neighboring organ, another is the pleura. Inflammation of the pleura. Then the disease is called as pleuropneumonia. For proper understanding of the disease, classification of pneumonia is very much important because many factors are working for the production of disease. So here we will see the four types of the classification. The first classification is according to the extension of infection with the neighboring tissue or organs. When it sends the infection to the bronchi, it is called as bronchopneumonia. Here the both are involved. Bronchi, bronchiole, alveoli and lung parenchyma. When the infection is sent to the pleura, inflammation of pleura, pleurisy, and lung parenchyma, alveoli, pleuropneumonia. So this is one classification. And symptoms according to the RO plot. Another classification is according to the origin of the causes. Where the causes are working. If the causes are working directly on the organ, alveoli, that is called as primary pneumonia. Because the etiology is working directly. Or caused by indirectly. Some other things happen and then pneumonia occur. That is called as secondary pneumonia. The third type of classification is etiology. That is called as etiological classification. When virus infection, viral pneumonia, bacterial causes, bacterial pneumonia, mycotic causes, mycotic pneumonia or fungal pneumonia, parasitic causes, parasitic pneumonia or famous name, verminous pneumonia. If the causes are allergic, allergic pneumonia. If the cause is aspiration, it is called as aspiration pneumonia. Or if the animal sits down or lie down long time by sitting or by lie down on the ground and blood accumulate gravitationally to the lower part, that is called as hypostatic pneumonia. The fourth type of pneumonia classification is according to the presence of lesion in the tissue. If the lesions are in alveoli, alveolar pneumonia, lesions in interstitial cells, interstitial pneumonia. If particular lobe is involved, lobar pneumonia. If a part of a lobe, lobule, lobar pneumonia. If it is by some fibrous tissue, a granulomatous one, just like tuberculosis granulomatous or sometimes cancerous type, that is called as fibrous or granulomatous pneumonia. If there is some block about the clots, embolic pneumonia. So these are the classification and they are based on various factors. These are important because to study the etiology, this is important. Now here we see various etiologies. First the virus etiology, virus pneumonia, this is also very common cause of disease. The viruses predisposes to the secondary bacterial invasion. So in this way, they are dangerous. First, they are coming to the alveoli, produce pneumonia, and they invite the bacterial infection. The example in cattle is viral pneumonia of the calf, a common infection in the calf. Parainfluenza, adenovirus, rhinovirus. In sheep and goat, sheep virus, sheeppox virus, goatpox virus. Influenza, adenovirus, rhinovirus. In horse, equine influenza, a very common. That cause a serious virus pneumonia in horses. In dog, important disease, canine distemper, adenovirus type 1 and type 2, and parainfluenza virus. Here I will talk about pathogenesis of virus pneumonia. Generally, the organism enter through respiration route called inhalation. There is inhalation of the droplets, and virus cause direct primary bronchiolitis. They directly cause infection to alveoli. Slowly the alveoli enlarges and proliferation of alveolar epithelial cells. Gradually there is alveolar edema. The space in the alveoli slowly reduces by a solid tissue that is called as consolidation. There is serous exudate mucus. And as there is consolidation, the air space decreases. It leads to hypoxia condition. There is thickening of the interstitial tissue. And gradually after a few days, there is secondary bacterial infection. So slowly, if timely treatment is not given, then it leads to a serious condition. Next to the virus, another important one etiology is the bacteria. In cattle, there are many bacteria. Few important are Streptococcus species, Staphylococcus species. Mycoplasma mycoides is also commonly occurring and it produces a disease, contagious bovine pleuropneumonia. Another important disease in cattle is Mycobacterium tuberculosis. It produces a granulomatous lesion. A very important bacterial causative agent in dog is Bordetella bronchoseptica. It is commonly known as canal cough. It is a famous disease. Many dogs in the canal are affected and showing coughing symptoms overnight. So this is a serious disease in dog. Pathogenesis of bacterial diseases. Generally the entry through inhalation or entry of bacteria through blood or entry of bacteria through lymphomatous route, through lymph, or by respiration, air. First, the bacteria cause primary bronchitis, then spread to the surrounding lung parenchyma, and there is a acute fibrinous changes. The common diseases are hemorrhagic septicemia, contagious bovine pleuropneumonia, contagious caprine pleuropneumonia, and there are necrotic lesions caused by necrobacillosis. Sometimes there is chronic disease, chronic fibrous type of the lesions, chronic granulomatous lesions caused by a famous disease, important disease, tuberculosis. And similar lesions are produced by the fungal infection also. Slowly the infection spread to bronchi and alveoli. Slowly there is reduction of the air spaces and increase in the solid tissue called consolidation. First, we have seen virus etiology, equally important bacterial pneumonia. Now, the mycotic pneumonia or caused by fungi. The fungus produce a granulomatous lesions, so it is called as granulomatous pneumonia. There are many fungi, but the common are Aspergillus fumigatus, causes aspergillosis, histoplasmosis, blastomycosis, cryptococcosis. Many protozoa produce pneumonia in dog, but the important one is caused by Toxoplasma gondii, called toxoplasmosis. Next important parasitic pneumonia or verminous pneumonia in cattle, it is caused by Dictyocallus viviparus and very commonly a migrating one, Ascaris in calf. In dog, common Phyllaroides, Eleurostrongylus, Paragonimus species, and very important Ankylostoma caninum. Through migration of larva, they enter into the lung. Many Toxocara species also. There are many parasites, but here, which are common, are named here. Now, with pathogenesis of parasitic pneumonia, there is ingestion of parasitic larva. The larva migrate. They invade alveoli and bronchi and cause the inflammation. We call it as a verminous pneumonia. There is thickening of alveolar wall. The larva migration of mature parasite to bronchiole and bronchi and causes inflammation of bronchiole and bronchi. They produce a thick mucus, and this mucus contain plenty of worms, and these worms are motile. Due to their motility, they cause irritation and severe coughing. This mucus contains larva, adult worm, and ova also. Apart from infectious causes, virus, bacteria, fungi, protozoa, parasites, there are physical and chemical causes also, non-infectious. Aspiration of material, for example, sometime vomitus, sometime aspiration of food, fluid, aspiration of drug, aspiration of chemical. They may occur accidentally while drenching or during dipping. They may also ingest this chemical fluid accidentally and it causes pneumonia. Inhalation of dust, irritant gases and chemicals. These causes a direct irritation of the mucous membrane. Slowly, there is edema, exudation, and inflammation of the mucosa of the tract. We call it as a pneumonia. Here we see mode of transmission. How this infection travels to alveoli. There are five routes of infection. One is infection cause direct effect on the alveoli. That is primary pneumonia. Sometimes infection in one part and they share the infection to the neighboring organ from trachea or bronchi or bronchus. Sometimes the infection enters through hematogenous route, spread from the systemic infection. Very good example is Pasteurella, Salmonella, Parasiticella. They enter through blood. Another route is they enter the lung through lymphatogenous route. Example is tuberculosis. Or the agent may enter through the wound from outside into the lung. And sometimes foreign body, they migrate from rumen or reticule. Accidental injury, penetrating foreign body from rumen or reticule. Thus, by these five routes, the agent enters into the lung and produces pneumonia. Dear veterinarian, you have seen the video. The video link and video thumbnail you will get from my Facebook message. I request all my veterinary brothers to share this information to many veterinarians so that we can provide real services to the animals, to the owner and to the veterinarian also. They can refresh their knowledge. If you like, press like button, but please subscribe this channel to promote and to sustain this channel. Thank you very much for observing this video, but don't forget to share to our professional brothers. Thank you very much.